Joining me is former Federal Labor Minister Gary Johns, who's now on the Committee of Australians for Unity, the No campaign against The Voice. Gary, great to catch up with you again. This Voice seems to me a con against Aborigines as well as whites. Aborigines in particular, because they're not going to be given a direct vote for the Voice that is meant to represent them. Can you explain that?
Oh, it's quite simple, Andrew. It's a corrupt system. By that I mean that Aboriginal CEOs will select themselves to become the 24 gifted people who will sit in Canberra and lobby for your taxpayers' dollars to get money for their organisations. That, if you like, it's an outing of the Aboriginal industry. That's how it's been designed.
I think that's absolutely correct, by the way. Plus, of course, someone, we don't know who, has to select the token youth votes voices as well. I mean, the whole thing is a stitch-up. Now, Indigenous Australians Minister Linda Burney, I mean, Gary, you must have noticed how she has struggled in Parliament to explain how this voice is actually going to work or fix anything. Yesterday, she claimed it would not even advise on changing Australia Day. Today, she said, oh, well, it would not fight culture wars. You know, she's backing off without saying she was wrong. What do you think this voice will actually do?
This is really interesting. She put her dainty little foot right in it. That inner city Aboriginal activist put her foot right in it. Look, we on the No case know that about 80% of Australians are really sensitive to any move to change Australia Day. And I reckon the government knows that too. So she's tried to rule it out, that the voice could not change Australia Day. Well, of course they want to lobby on that. It says that this voice will advise government on any matters that affect Aboriginal people. Well, Aboriginal people are a modern people. Everything affects them. And since 1988, some of them have been campaigning against Australia Day, which, by the way, was a date set in 1948 in the Citizenship Act, which made us Australian citizens as opposed to British subjects. So it was a moment of unity, just like the 1967 referendum. This referendum divides us, and she's been caught out trying to cover it up.
Yeah, I think it's so ridiculous. It's so transparent, Gary. We have on one side Labor politicians like the Prime Minister, like Linda Burney, say, oh, this voice is just a modest change, just modest, don't worry about it. It won't get political. It's just going to stick to issues that directly affect the Aborigines, even though the legislation doesn't say that. On the other, we get the activists appointed by the government to actually design the voice saying, well, in fact, we can do things like destroy colonialist institutions, argue for Australia Day to be changed. We can advise everyone from the Reserve Bank to Centrelink and the Great Barrier Marine Park Authority. We can do anything. Who do we believe then? Labor or its Aboriginal advisors?
The Aboriginal advisors. I mean, they're the ones who stood behind Prime Minister Albanese when he wept over the words that he was forced to make part of the referendum. And remember, Professor Megan Davis said, you won't be able to shut this voice up. She is on record of saying that, and she also said it will advise on everything to do with government. So if I were backing someone, I'd back the 21 advisers, the working party that stood behind the Prime Minister, in fact, rolled the Australian Prime Minister and the Australian Cabinet, your government, to get the words they wanted, the power they want to express through the Constitution. So I'd be listening to Megan Davis and others like that.
Well, they're going to be using the voice, so I don't know whether the Prime Minister's word can be taken at all. Gary Johns, thank you so much indeed for fighting the good fight.